I don't know how easy this is going to be to do. Quite difficult, I suspect. It's a video mainly for a guy called John Cox. I'll put a link to his channel and also to the video that is inspiring me to do this, which is on autism and about his autistic daughter. And this is not going to be an academic presentation, and the reason for that is because I connect and relate to the autistic very well. Always have. It's something I discovered when I was about 13 and explored in depth at the time, and have worked with many autistic children over the years and whom I've felt a huge connection with. Autism is a really complex and confusing condition. It's not a disability. It can be part of a disability. The difficulty with it is, and why I've titled the video as I have, is because there is the assumption that this label means that the person who has it is somehow less than normal and has problems. Now that can be the case. Someone who is autistic can also have attendant mental impairments, sometimes to a huge degree, which means they have no speech, no ability to connect or to socialise in any real way. And that makes it very hard for them to make the autism that they have anything like a gift. But you can also have people who are precociously intelligent with autism. So it's not attached to any level of intelligence. It's also such a complex condition that you can have almost opposite ends of a spectrum. Like, for example, someone with Asperger's often, though not always, finds it very difficult to engage or to comprehend the emotions that other people have. But at the other extreme, and an extreme which I am personally very familiar with, you are overwhelmed with others' feelings because they become your feelings. You're kind of swamped by them. One of the things about autism is often that it's very difficult to define your edges, and that can be why so many seek to make sense of life by ordering it in a particular way. I'm kind of on the cusp, but I don't think anyone would actually classify me as autistic, but I suspect that John, you haven't either. Some of the things that happened in your video and that your daughter said really struck me. One of the things was that you said to her, I was talking about when she said a lady was fat, and you said that's inappropriate. And in the society that we live in, yeah, perhaps it is. But does that mean it's wrong? One of the things that, I mean, I can't lie. I just can't do it. It doesn't work for me at all. Because I don't have compartments inside me in the same way that a lot of people seem to have. The tension and if I've ever tried, the stress that it causes me is phenomenal. It doesn't make any sense anyway. Why would you lie? Why would we have a set of structures in society which made lying a necessity, and it is polite to lie? It just doesn't. It's illogical, completely illogical. So while I understand why you said that, I also understand why your daughter does what she does. I have been that way. I mean, I earlier in life would speak what I thought without monitoring it, without considering it, and hurt people. And I quite quickly learned that that wasn't a very good idea. So that tendency doesn't mean that you have to then become like everybody else. I mean, I think, you know, one of the things that's really important for anybody really, but particularly somebody who has autistic tendencies, is that they don't lose that they embrace it and learn how to use it in their lives in a valuable way. So I have learned how to be very diplomatic. I have learned when to keep my mouth shut, mostly. I have learned how to say things in a way that other people find acceptable, so that I'm being authentic to myself, but I am doing it in such a way that I don't cause somebody else real distress. And I think, you know, an autistic person with intelligence, which your daughter clearly has, can learn that skill. What else did she say? She said something else. Oh yes, she talked about your fake smile, and I think that again exemplifies how very insightful autistic people can be, and that far from not being able to read emotions, they read them far better than others and can't make sense of why there is a level of inauthenticity going on. You know, why would you fake a smile? What would the purpose be of that? It doesn't make sense to me either. I mean, I can kind of, you know, I can rationalize. One of the main reasons I studied psychology was because humans didn't make sense to me. And they still don't make sense to me. I think the way they behave is often completely ridiculous and preposterous and absurd. But I have a better handle on why they do it, why they think it makes sense. I could go on and on here. And I tried to make this before and made a bit of a pig's ear of it. It's a difficult subject to talk about. So rather than going and doing that, I think what I'll do is I'll leave it there and open it to you. And if you want to start a dialogue, whether it's just with you or whether you and your partner or even your daughter, if you want to include her, that would be great. I would enjoy that kind of communication. Also, Serge, if you're interested, this is a friend of mine on YouTube who has Asperger's, if you want to, you know, get involved, that would be brilliant too. Or anyone else who either is or isn't autistic or who has these tendencies or who is interested in this. I personally feel that people who are autistic have something huge to offer, and so rather than trying to train them into being something that they simply aren't, that we should encourage them to become who they are really well, so that they can fit in their own unique way and therefore offer what they have to bring and receive. As I said, there's a lot more that I could say, but I think it's probably wiser if I leave it there for now.